Hey guys, how's it going? It's Amanda. So it's back to school time, and as much as we all hate it, you're going to be doing a little bit of shopping for some things that's going to get you through the semester, and one of those things might be either an iPad Pro or a MacBook Pro. Now, I have both 2017 models, and we're going to go over some of the things that I love about each of them and kind of help you make your decision. So I have the 13-inch with Touch Bar and Touch ID, and that rings in at $1,799. Well, that's a crap ton of money to spend, so maybe you guys can pick up the new 10.5-inch iPad Pro. It's still going to give you a beautiful display, a lot of computing power, and it comes in at only $649. Now, there are different options of each of these. You can definitely get bigger storage and upgrade things in the new MacBooks and get these things up to like $4,000, but we're just going to kind of go over some of the base models here. In the end, you can still just pick up your textbook along with a notebook and a pen and get by just fine. But having Google right in the power of your hands, along with these beautiful machines that Apple makes, it just definitely makes the whole process a lot simpler, and I'll show you some of the ways. All right, guys, stop what you're doing. If you know that you need Windows and full versions of Windows apps, your MacBook can do that, or you can pick up a Windows computer for much cheaper. So check in with your class and make sure there's nothing required, a certain app or anything. There is definitely options for alternatives on the MacBook to both things like Photoshop and PowerPoint and Microsoft Word, but there's not the full versions of apps, so definitely check that out before you jump in. So I'm just gonna be honest from the beginning. Let's jump right in, but my pick for you is going to be the iPad Pro. With this beautiful big touchscreen display, the thinner bezels that have been reduced in the 2017 model. Yes, they are still bezels there, but check this out, guys. Whenever you reach down and pick this up, you don't want to constantly be touching the display, triggering things to be happening, and also covering up everything, so that's why they're there. But this is a thin and light and beautiful device, and it weighs like a pound, so most of you won't even notice that weight in your bag. So this may or may not apply to some of you because you may not want the extra plan, but with the new iPad Pro, you can add a data plan. So you have got the power of all the internet in your hands at anywhere, just like you would with your cell phone. Also, a big thanks to Verizon for sending this out and letting me share my thoughts with you. Another thing the iPad has is both front and rear cameras, and you can hit up that selfie game or you can take photos. And the app and camera that's built in this is the same as found on the iPhone 7, I believe. So you know it's got some really good camera quality. And here's just a quick example. You may not want to run around taking photos, but this thing is just inches away from my keyboard, which is just inches away from my camera, and you can see how clear it is, and maybe you want to take a picture of a handout or something and include it in your notes. Also, it's a good thing to note that iOS 11 is gonna unleash some of the power of this device, and it's not actually out right now, it's in beta. I'll show you some of the things that it can do, but it really steps up the game as using the iPad Pro as a laptop replacement. And again, I'll show you some of those things, but just know in like a few weeks, Apple's supposed to be updating it, I believe, and putting it out to public in the full version, so definitely look for that. So the iPad Pro is not a pro unless you have the Apple Pencil, so expect to spend that extra $100 for it, but just check this out. You have to have your screen woke, and once you have your pencil in your hand, you tap it on the screen, boom, just like that, it opens up your notes, and that's just a super quick way to be able to quickly be able to take down notes and not miss out on anything. Now, if you want to step up your note game, Notability is a $10 app that works really great. It lets you really bring your notes to life. You can add pictures, you can really customize the colors, you can use grid or lines or blank papers, different types of lead or pen tips. And one of the really cool things I love about it is the fact that it has a listenability. So just like that, you can record a lecture while sitting in class and add it right into your notes as you go. So please excuse the messiness of this, but here is a note I took just to kind of show you guys. You can see the thin and bold lines. You can see the highlighter up at the top looks very authentic, just like it would if you were scribbling over it multiple times. It gets darker as you layer it. You can see I inserted a picture there. You can see my writing even went over the top of it, and I could have cropped it down smaller, but I just left it there to kind of show you authentically what it would look like if you were using this to take your notes. And again, I haven't unleashed half of the power of this app. There's so many things you can do. Another thing we have in iOS 11 is this new dock, and it's very much like what you would find on a Mac. But here you can see I just grabbed something from that dock and I slid it over, and boom, just like that, you now have those both apps open side by side. Here I'm grabbing something from Safari, clicking that picture and dragging it into notes, and just like that, it inserts it right into my notes. I don't have to search for it. I don't have to click download or save and then open it up in the notes app and search for it on my iPad, excuse me. It's just right there just like that. Very convenient. I'm sure you've all seen that Apple has a smart keyboard for that, but there is a built-in keyboard on screen that you can use. Now, it's not always the most convenient for long-term typing, so at home you may want to check out a Bluetooth keyboard that you already have, see if it'll pair up, but you can pick up a smart one or even some other smart accessories. Here I have the Logitech Base, which is a charging stand. It also is just a nice convenient stand to have on your desk to just prop it up if you're going to watch movies or anything. But just like that, you set it on there. It's plugged in via a lightning cable on the back and it starts charging. Now you can still use your standard lightning port at the bottom. I just find it much more convenient just to be able to sit it down, and it also doubles as a stand. Files. Thank you so much, Apple, for finally giving us access to files. Now you can't dive deep into your iPad's settings and file systems and all that, but you can save things from emails or messages. You can work on PDFs or save some homework you're working on, things like that, and access it from either the cloud, your iPad itself, or you can even send it to something like this thumb drive. I have this one from SanDisk, and it's a wireless thumb drive. So what it does is it creates its own connection. You don't have to have Wi-Fi, but it creates its own Wi-Fi connection to your device, whether you're using the iPad or MacBook. And it's just a super easy way to transfer things and offload things to save storage. Another perk of having the iPad Pro is a lot of your books can be downloaded in PDF or from iBooks, or even like Amazon has their Kindle library. A lot of these can be downloaded, and just check out how realistic this is. This is just right in your hands. You use your fingers just like you would be turning on a page. If you're on a MacBook, you're gonna be hitting like page, next page, or clicking a mouse thing. Right here with the iPad, if your books are available, sometimes they're even cheaper and you can just get them on rental and you don't have to worry about running to the bookstore or running back and forth. Right here you can see you can highlight in them. You can double tap and hold, and whenever you do that, it's gonna pop up. You can't really read it because it's not quite so clear because it's still focused on the print on the backside, but it pops up info, a definition, and links to things pertaining to that word. It's just a really awesome, useful tool if you can find the books that you need. So far we've focused on ways to be productive. There's a multitude of other ways to be productive. There's also some great ways to get some downtime and relax. Obviously you have all these apps like Netflix and Amazon Videos that you can check out some of your latest shows, chill out, get some downtime, and really the built-in speakers on this are some of the best I've ever heard. Yes, Apple does still have a built-in headphone jack, so you have that wired option if you need it. Or if you'd like a wireless option, I've been checking out these Sennheiser 4.50, HD 4.50, I believe is what they're called. Killer sound for under $200. Also, if you're into gaming, you have an unlimited amount of games, both free and paid, in the App Store. Now, this is not a super intense graphical game. It's just one of my favorites right now. But if you are a big gamer, you will be pleased to know that the newest version of the iPad Pro does support 120Hz refresh rate, which is just insane. It's super smooth. But the good thing is it doesn't use that refresh rate at all times. It just uses it when it needs it to push through things. That way you can conserve battery and not have to worry about it just instantly draining it. So here we can see the 10.5-inch iPad Pro sitting on top of the 13-inch MacBook Pro. You can see there's definitely some size difference there. But in the end, I feel if you can get the iPad Pro and utilize it, you can save from carrying the MacBook, your book, your notebook, your pen. I guess you will still have to have a pen, but your charger, depending on how many classes you have, how many books you have, how many notebooks you have, you can just condense it all down to this. Again, if your classes allow for that. So by no means am I discouraging you from picking up the new MacBook Pro. You don't even have to pick up the Touch Bar version if you're just doing basic things. You can get the $12.99 or whatever it is, cheapest model. You will still have two USB-C ports, but I wanted the four USB-C ports because if I'm going to be using dongles and adapters, I want to be able to have the most access to them as I can have because I have many things that I tend to do over time. This one from Satechi really does a good job. It has your micro SD, your SD card. It has pass-through charging, two USB ports, two USB-C ports, and it uses two to connect in. And even on the end here, you've got an HDMI. Also, some things are just easier and better, like typing on the keyboard is much easier than the on-screen one with the iPad. You do have the navigation. Instead of having to use the touchscreen and get it all dirty, you can use the touchpad, and in some cases it's just easier than reaching up and touching the screen. So I hope I've showed you some ways that you can help make your decision. Both of these devices have very good computing power. They're not the most powerful, in quotes, computers. However, with Apple's optimization, they're very good at what they do. So again, as I've stated, I think my first choice would definitely be checking out the iPad Pro. Many places you can pick one up and use it for 30 days, test it out. If not, you can go back and pick up the MacBook if you need to, or even some other computer. But leave a comment down below letting me know which one you would pick, or if you have any suggestions of apps that other students should check out. Well guys, that wraps it up for today's video. I'm working on a new video for Back to School Tech, so make sure you check the channel out for that in the next couple of days. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.